We have the message for you right on the table. We have a defender. Hallelujah. So it's on the table. But time will not actually, because of many activities we have today. I want to once appeal to the people that are waiting to share their testimony. We have at least 900 people on the list that want to share their testimony of anointing water. Out of 900, almost 700 actually came from other countries. But what can we do? I want to appeal to them. Out of 900, only 2 to 3 people that share their testimony today. So I want to appeal to you, please bear with me. After the service, I will find time to listen to you and bless you more. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That you are here today from your country far east, southwest, to share your testimony. Already, this is really true that you have given that testimony already. And thank you very much. Don't let us forget today. Today is set aside for fathers. This means fathers are special and unique. I want to say Happy Father Day. I want to join other boys to say Happy Father Days. Once again, Happy Father's Day. Hallelujah. And then once again, I want to say thank you very much for your prayer and your support, especially during my 50th birthday celebration. Thank you for your prayer and support. Well are not enough. I think in a little way, let me say thank you for your prayer. Thank you for your support. And making that day, because the Lord reveals to me trillion people were on their knees praying for me. Thank you once again. Thank you. You remain blessed. In Jesus' name. Amen. As my love and my prayer are with you, remain blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, I think in a little way, please take it. If you see my heart, you know my heart go for you. I pray with you all the time. My prayer and my love are with you. Are with you. Imagine millions of people on their knees praying for me. You know that why your prayer counts. Thank you once again. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yes, I want to remind you once again the God's program for us. Creating job creation. For the past 1 week now, we have been running. We have received a lot of response. There's need for me to mention, to let them know that we have received their email, their letter, asking for people they want to employ. I mean, all over the world. All over the world. I think I will ask them to bring a few out, because we are going to set a panel that will go through this letter email. All over the country, all over the world. Like I have said, the job in each country will belong to that country. All I need to do is to say it on Imane TV and run it. If the people who want to give job are in South Africa, when I'm running this advert on Imane TV, they will put the location and the place where they can meet them. They will do the screening, and the final list, they will send it to us here. We now present this final list to God. And now look beyond the qualification, character. Examine their character so that this will not affect our relationship. So we will not employ somebody who will not stand test of time, in future. So we want to guide against this, that as you do your own side, by looking at their qualification, those who are qualified for the job, the final list, you send it to us. We prayer warrior will pray to confirm, examine the character behind the qualification. And we send it to you, and you go ahead and employ them. Like I have said, love is the greatest. We do not need to ask you whether you are a Christian or what religion you are belong. When you have a good job and the Lord give you a job, you get a job from God, you have sense of judgment. You will be able to think and judge right. Once you are able to think right and judge right, you will know the living God. If before now you don't know the living God before you get the job, you will accept the living God. So, saying you must be this, you must be a member of the synagogue, you must be a Christian, you must be this, you must that. No, that is not the criteria. What the issue is, we want food on your table. Food from God. And when you eat God's food, you accept God. So once again, we are talking, the number of people sitting down, they are not up to 1% of people watching Imane TV. We that are here, we are not up to 0.5% of people that are watching Imane TV, that are under the influence of this telecast. So I'm talking to the whole world. When you browse your internet, you see that the Imane TV is leading watching station, Christian, as we are talking now. So I'm talking to the whole world. So what I'm saying, this job issue, to create job, we don't need to ask you whether you belong to this, or you're a member of synagogue, or a Christian, or Muslim. You are a human being. You need job, and you are qualified for that job. They will give you. If God give you job, and you take God's job, you must accept God.
Hallelujah.
Yes. If God gave you the job, and you start working. And before now, you don't know the presence of God, you don't know what we talk about. The sense of judgment will come. You will think right, judge right. You will have desire to know what happened after this life. After this life is over. After this life is over, you have desire to know what happiness after this life is what? You will think about that. If God given you a job. So once again, it's not issue of, we are talking of job, people, if you are qualified, all over the world, if that job is in your country, we call the people, the company that want to provide the job in that country. We get their address, their telephone number, the location. That country, that those who qualify in that country will locate the company, and they will be the one to screen you. We stand for you. After doing the final screening and you are qualified, they will now send your name to us. We pray to ask God, who are these people? Our prayer does not mean that if you are not a Christian, if you are not this, if you are a Muslim, we remove you. No. We want to know, after giving you a job, will you accept the relationship, good relationship? Think right, act right. So it's not issue of Christian or so far you are a human being. You deserve, you have the qualification, you will be given the job. So thank you very much. So we can just call one or two of different countries, because we have email almost 7 countries now. We have almost 10 email from each country for the graduates. So you just read 1, 2, 1, 1, 1 on in each country, because the time is not on our side. We want to create time for this. And all this will be put in on Emmanuel TV. Mm-hmm.
We have received many, many emails of job offer after the man of God made the announcement. And right now we're just going to read few out of those many emails that we have received. The first email we're reading is from the chairman and chief executive officer of a group of company in Abuja.
Please take it easy. Let us understand you. Tell us the country, each country. Will you give to sister or whatever, please?
The first set of emails we are reading are for job offers here in Nigeria. And the email is coming in.
So he's going to read 1 out of 100 email. We cannot read all, but just he will pick 1 out of the 100. Okay. It's a very serious issue, because we really want to work on this. If that is the project God gave me and gave you this time, I think it's a big project, because it's going to affect the crime. It will reduce the crime and what is happening to our youth all over the world. So they want to work. Not that many of them, not that they really desire for this crime, but sometimes when they don't have anything to do, anything can overwhelm them. If when you don't have anything to do, anything can overwhelm you. And when you don't have anything to do, anything can work. You just find yourself being carried away because you want food. Okay? Thank you. Just 1 in each country. Okay?
The email is for job offer here in Nigeria. And it's coming in from the chairman and the chief executive officer of a group of company located in Abuja. It said, "Dear man of God, I'm the chairman and the chief executive officer of the following group of companies. Number 1, a construction and commercial company, a saving and loans company, and top hotel and suites, all located in Abuja. And the following professionals are needed for immediate employment in the company. Number 1, 3 structural engineers, 2 building engineers, 1 surveyor, 6 employees as hotel assistants, and 1 experienced mortgage banker as assistant manager, and 1 experienced mortgage banker as general manager."
This job we are talking about, not like this now, you know, like I used to say, we are not up to 0.5% that are under the influence of this immanent evil. Many homes. When I say I need this, some people say, we have not done anything to this man. Whatever he needs, we are ready to do it. So they have to, like this now, he just say, oh, this is opportunity to help this man. And they have to, yes. And they know the dividend, one of the dividend they will enjoy, I will join their company as a member. The wise men will join the company as a member, which will, if they need to come to the company, if there is need to us to go there and look around and monitor the development, we are ready. We just want to see the company prosper. Yes. We just want to see the company prosper because of the people he employs, people that are out there on the street, bringing them, giving them job, transforming their life. Our duty too is to follow the company up, praying for the company. I mean, cancer from time to time, the company, the family behind the company, the workers and everything. It's like the company becoming synagogue. We pray to make sure things go well because of the people they are employing. So the dividend is big. We are ready. So this is, and you can hear this, one of the big company, almost seven countries under this email. Okay, can you take another email? This is one in Nigeria. We have almost 200 email they have sent. They want to employ. So we have to properly handle this case. It's a blessing from God. So I have never come out one day and say, this is what I need, but thank God today. So we are not saying we want to build cathedral, we need donation, but they have not heard that from us from right from the beginning of the synagogue. But if that this is what I need now, to make sure people, I mean, you have food on the table. It's blessing to me, blessing to you, blessing to every one of us, and nation as well. So thank you. As we are saying this, I know many people that have been watching Manna TV all over the world, please take your pen and send us email. Tell us those available places in your company. There are many things you are doing that you know you can employ 6-4 people to do. You need to rest. You need to supervise the company. It's not, you go home, you go out 8 a.m., you come back 12 midnight. It's not good for health. You should bring people in, bring some graduates, bring them in. As you bring them in, when you employ some, God increase your responsibility. Thank you. So that is Nigeria, 1 out of 100 or 200, another country.
We have also received many emails from different countries, South Africa, Zimbabwe, Tanzania. Right now, I am going to read one from Kenya. He said, I have 3 companies, a consultancy and recruitment agency, a travel company, and an international trading company. The consultancy and recruitment company is one of the leading companies in Kenya that is creating employment. I want to employ 10 employees on each one of them and connect another 300 people employment through my recruitment agency.
Yes. This, in each country, there are so many unemployment. Unless there is no people, no graduate, nobody in Kenya that need the job, that will allow any country to go there and take the job. After the Kenyan have taken the job, the graduate there, those unemployment people, if there's anyone, there's no one to face, we can look into. We are going to call Kenyan people, come out. This is job opportunity for you. And the man in charge, I will invite them. If I need to travel to Kenya to meet him, I will do that. So to thank him and to pray with him and to let him know that his pain is my pain, his challenges is my challenges. So he should be the one to do the screening and do the interview. After finish 100 people he need, now he can send their name to me. I will pray to know these people, are they the right people? I will look beyond the qualification. So now I can now say, okay, go ahead and employ them. So now, then the company is also a brothers to Synagogue Church of Our Nation. So thank you. Can you take one more? The one from Philippines? Okay. Or any other? Please, any other because of time.
So we have another job offer here in Nigeria, and it's coming in from the chairman and chief executive officer of a group of companies. He said, "Dear Prophet, sir, I have automatically created 10 employment chances for you to share to any unemployed youth of your choice. I must partake in this great commission and bring God's divine presence in my company's 110%. These 10 chances will be spread across 5 of my companies. These companies are providing engineering support services for Shell in Nigeria, and those 10 persons will be engaged and deployed as soon as possible. The companies are oil and gas pipeline engineering work and oil production operations. The second company is a gas compression and gas processing and facility works. The third company is Oil Producing Limited, which is setting up its own operation to own an oil block for exploration and production of oil products. And the fourth company is a dredging company. And the fifth company is a total marine logistics services and support company." He said, "God bless you, Prophet T.B. Joshua, and I'm ready to be in your presence as soon as possible to offer this job opportunities."
Where is the man that sent this email?
The man is right now in the United States of America, but he has 5 companies based here in Nigeria.
Okay, thank you. Okay, another country, because call it today because of time.
Yes, I have another one here from South Africa. He said he is an engineer and he's from South Africa and he's a regular follower of Emmanuel TV. He said, "I own 2 companies, of which one is 100% mine, an engineering consulting company, while the other I am 50% shareholder. I am prepared to employ 10 graduates regardless of where they come from. In fact, I will have to employ one already next week."
Okay, because of time, I think we continue. This is first week of my birthday. I want to move on. So this is job for South Africa people. Everyone, I mean, we are going to say it on the Money TV, which people watch. Let South Africa unemployment people and the graduates, those who are qualified to take the job, they will meet the company, they will screen them, get in the right people. They can now send their name to me. Here, we pray. And finally look beyond the certificate and send it back, approval. So then the company. We have so many email here from different countries. Different countries. So I have given a call. Before I can begin to talk here, I've called those chairmen of the company to talk to them. And I begin to have that comfort that the right person is talking to me. So please join me. Those of us that will not be able to provide the job, we provide it by contributing money in certain account. So it's not everybody we can get that job. but that some people too, we can give some capital and train them how to do business. So thank you, because of time. So please, you just keep it, we continue. So we place everything on humanity. And make sure we monitor it so that it will not go to the wrong hand. Like I have said once again, love is the greatest. I don't need to ask you whether you, the religions, whether the denomination you belong, are you Muslim, are you Christian, are you this, are you that? No. I believe one thing. Our God that rains sun, rain water on us, he never asks whether the Christian or Muslim that are enjoying the rain. The rain fall on all of us, we all enjoying the rain. The sun shine on all, we all enjoying the sun. So he will not, deny you this because you are not a Christian or you are not this. He give you, yes, so that you can have sense of judgment. You can think and judge right. So please, what we are talking about is not issue of synagogue member, Christian, or this alone. No, every human being created by God. So when you have food on your table, I know you think right. You begin to have desire to know what will happen after this life is over. So we pray. So there is no fear. Yes. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you very much. And once again, you should also believe that people that are providing this job, are they all Christian? Eh? No. Yeah! Many of them are not Christian. Why should I say this job should be for Christian alone? When you look at 100 people that are providing, chairman, owner of the company, BB company, that are saying, oh, this man say he want to employ people. I want to give a job in my company. Are they all Christian? Answer the question. So can you see the sense of thinking, reason? Why should we now say the cathedral should be also before you can get the job? No. Because people give up the job. They believe you deserve to have food on the table. Food first. Before ask me, what is my name? Give me food. After giving me food, after eating, you can ask me, what is my name? You may choose not to tell me your name. You may choose to tell me. That will not remove that food from your stomach. But you want to give a food, someone who is very, very hungry, and you are now saying, what is your name? Tell me your name before I give you food. That means that food is not from God. For selfish, for classic, and for material reason. If you are given something for selfish reason, what is your name? You are looking for Joseph before giving food. When you say, I'm Muhammad, you say, ah, no, my food is not for you. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Once again, I want to appeal, because as I'm talking now, I know many people are prepare to send email. If there's no job in your company and you have company all over the world, you can create it. Yes. you can create it just to appeal to the youth that are on the street, the graduates, undergraduates, I mean, graduate people out there. Please, that is the best blessing, one of the best blessings you can give at this time of economic crisis, economic meltdown, and you want to bless the nation, you want to bless God himself. You just look for someone who is looking for a job and fix him. Fix him. That is the greater blessing. Get him something to do. Get him something to do. So please, I know those who, my message just reaching them now. We have been on this for the past 2 weeks now. I want you to know that it's my desire to see people find something to do. You will have to work. People want to work. Cook judgment. Say, I don't know, look at him, he's a stupid boy, he's a drunkard, he's a criminal. It's too quick to say that. Someone you call criminal, give him job and see whether he will not leave the arts. He says he's a smoker, he's a drunkard. Look at him, stupid. It's not serious. It's too quick. Fix him, give him job and see whether he will not abandon the arts. So when you say I'm a drunkard, I'm a criminal, I'm this, have you once fixed me and I abandoned the job? Try this. That is the best way to approach the situation we are, the challenges we are facing today. Yes. There's so much crime. Association can change. When you have a good association, you have been moving with bad association, bad society, and you are taken from one society to another association. That can change your focus, change your idea, your reason, your thinking will change automatically. So we are trying to prepare a sticker now that will bear this logo, job creation. So it will be everywhere. You place it on your door. When you open your door, you see it. Ah, I must create job. When you are sleeping in the night, you see it right on your bed. I must create job. You look this way, you see job creation everywhere, job. Even you have sticker on your bag, you place it in your bag, your body. You begin to carry it like your badge. So say, job. You have to create job. That is the answer. So, thank you, and I know my message is with you. Rise up. So let us give thanks to God for giving you the grace to be here today. I'm talking to you because I know you are in position. If you are not in position and I'm talking to you, it means you are about to be in position. You are about to be. That is next. You are next now. You are next. So give thanks to God, give thanks to him. Like I have said it, said it all. Those of us that cannot create job, your money will create job. Your possession will create job. No matter how little you are, you should be able to give part with it. No matter how little, you part with it. And let us put them together with million, with one pen, with $1, with $1 million, putting them together, you are part of that project. You must be part of that project. As you create job for others, God increase your responsibility. But God wants to give you bigger responsibility. Yes. So that you have abundance and you can feed the world. Father, thank you. In Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
You may be seated. I want to spend just some minutes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I want to spend just some minutes. I don't know. Look at the crowd. Look at it. Look at it. Where will I, which direction will I follow? Don't forget, you watch Emmanuel TV. Don't forget last Sunday. Assume I did not follow God's direction, I would not have met that woman. Last Sunday, assume I did not listen to the voice of Holy Ghost, I would have taken this direction last Sunday. Assume I took this direction, that lady will not have opportunity to talk. Because I will have earned the hurt here. And here, I will just say the grace, the wise men will come. But I listened to the voice of Holy Spirit. I allowed the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Father, to suggest to me. I allowed myself to be used by that Spirit of God. And before I moved last Sunday, I watched, I knew, the Lord said, the job is here for you. Not that there is no job for me here, but more importantly, so I have to follow the direction. When I was walking, the lady, towards the end, I was about to finish, the lady just came out. It embarrassed me. I thought he wanted to say to me, TB Joshua, pray for me. But he was telling me, the whole world was listening, saying, someone is on the way. I say, someone is on the way. You are saying this publicly. Are you a tempter? Are you a tempter? I look at myself, I say, ah, help me. My mommy is on the way. My mommy is on the way. He has been on the way. I say, ah, okay, don't worry, don't worry. When I now look at the way you are looking at me, people are saying, oh God, God has sent to this person. Even the man was about to attend to. Instead of listening to me, say, go attend to that woman, attend to that woman, attend to that woman, attend to that woman, and say, ah, this is temptation. Does it mean now if I did not attend to that woman, you begin to, look at my limitation. Oh, this is what this man can do. He can do this one, this is this one, he cannot do it. And God does not allow you people to know the limitation of the prophet. That is the grace we have. So the Bible says, I can do all things. Are you with me? God does not allow you. You want to know what the prophet can do and what prophet cannot do. But God on his side, he said, no. I can do all things. Through who? Who are? But everybody know your limitation. Yeah, outside there they know if you don't have money, when you are broke, people say, look at your friend, he has no money. They say, how are you, sir? They will now begin to make jest of you. Say, look at your friend, he's going. As you are looking at him, he has no money. Oh, he has no money. Okay, come, how are you? Can I borrow you money? Oh, thank you, I don't have money. Shebe, I told you, he has no money. They know what can happen to you for you to, shed tear. They know what will happen to you for you to laugh. They know what will happen to you for you to be quiet and silent. They know what will happen to you that you start dancing. People notice this. They know your limitation. And they know how they can embarrass you. They know how they can make you happy. They know how they can make you sad. Look, many of us are here today. We have many that are not in the church because their vehicle knock engine. Satan knows that, what can I do to this man? Let me touch his car engine. If I stop his car engine, he will not worship God. And truly, when you wake up in the morning, you start your vehicle, the vehicle, Emmanuel, you must allow this vehicle to work if you want me to come to church today. Start it again. Where is that anointing water? Give me. The wife will run and bring anointing water. They'll spray it. And spray anointing water on the engine. You are killing the engine. Because it's water. Huh? Engine that need to be to dry. You are now spraying what? Oh, yeah. The engine need to dry. But now you are now pouring water again. Well, God does not want me to go to church. Who told you that God does not want you to go to church? Eh? Because the engine is no. The language is, if God wants me to go to church, the engine must work. No, God does not want us to go to church. Don't worry. That is, Satan know what he can do to stop your relationship with God. He know. Sometimes when you ask, pray, you say, oh my God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Satan will just allow a sad call. Somebody will call, you take it and say, hello? He's in the hospital. Who is in the hospital? Who? You are forgetting your prayer. See, Satan know you, and he's supposed not to know you. You know the reason why people will call you any name? When what people don't understand, they call name. And what they understand, they destroy. When they understand you, they destroy you. But when they don't understand you, they begin to call you all sort of name. Is this, is that, is this, is that, is this, is that. Because they don't understand your way. They don't really understand you. When they expecting you to wait, you walk. When they expecting you to sleep, you talk. When they expecting you to stand, you see. They say, it's devil, it's this, it's this. And if you are sitting when they expecting you to sit, they will destroy you. So once they know your limitation, you are finished. For your information, everyone has limitation. But we that are born of God, only God know our limitation. Amen. Tell your neighbor, everyone has limitation. But we that are born of Jesus, only Him know our limitation. I will not cry to you when I know you cannot solve my problem. But the situation you are facing today, when you have a wound, you begin to do like this. You are expecting someone to say sorry. When they say sorry, you begin to get better. Okay? You say sorry.
Sorry.
Because I enjoy that sorry. The more you say sorry, the more I get healed. I get better. And even if there's anyone among them that refuse to say sorry, I will say, you can't just see me. Can't you see that I cannot walk well? That is your weakness. The weakness is so much that Satan has now used that to rubbish you. Are you talking of when you help someone and the other day you meet the person and the person refuses to greet you? You are mad. You say, oh my God, after helping this sister, he refused to greet me. Okay, how are you? You don't want to greet me? Have I done you wrong? As if she's the one you help. you have forgotten that you are doing it for God. You keep complaining. Satan know you so much, and we supposed not to be. You point to people and say, oh, this man, I help him, I brought him from the village, and I sent him to school, I helped him, and he graduated. Now he's a big man. I was the one who sent him to school, I sponsored him, I pay his school fee. Look at him. He refused to call, take my call. He refused to even look at me. Look at him. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that? If you send someone to school and you send someone to university and the person becomes great, why can't you also do the same thing to your children if you are the one doing it? You say you send somebody to school and the person becomes great. You send him to university, you pay his school fees, you brought him from the village, and he now is a big man. If you are the one that make someone big, what of your children at home? Why can't you make your children big? It's God, not you. Anytime you see someone who is saying, I know we are schoolmates. When I was in school, he was the one who helped. I helped him. I used to help him. Now he has forgotten me. In fact, I loaned him money. I helped him. I gave him money. Now he's great. But he doesn't want to see me. I don't know what I've done. I mean, you hear people say, people have done good too. They pay me bad. See you. How do you pay God? The Lord that raised you from embryo. How are you paying God? If you have been paying God good, will you your life remain like this? So these are the challenges we are facing so much that you make someone great, you send someone to school, you sponsor someone, you give scholarship to someone, to university. Today he's become a great man, a commissioner, a governor of a nation. Wow. If you are the one that actually make that man that what he is, you have children. Why can't you make one of your children the same, the maker? You can make your children the same. You are not the one. God can use any foolish thing to build an empire. So, where are we going? I want to say thank you for my birthday once again. And I want to wish you happy birthday. Happy birthday in Nigeria. Thank you. Viewers all over the world. So we all the time we battle with the time. As if we should have more time every time. Well, God's time is our time. What can we do about that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So last time I told you that at 50, the Lord said there's need to reveal the covenant, to re-examine. What are you doing, this boy? Yes. Which is normal. What are you doing? I mean, your responsibility I gave you, how do you go about it? Are you using it to acquire wealth or property, or what for salvation? You are sent to save the lost soul. That is examine. So in the same way, you also, in every, there's need to examine you. If you believe you can do better than what you are doing now, mean you need God. more than before. You need to improve, I need to improve. Only God supreme. You need to improve, I need to improve. If I need to improve, mean I need God more than ever before. If what you are doing now, you know how you achieve what you have achieved now. You know how you achieve what you have achieved now. If you want to achieve better than what you have achieved now, it means you have to think wide, wiser than now. Wiser. You mean not need many things that is around you. And many things around you, if you need them, they need to also be reformed. So I want, let me just be with as we move, the little time I have, I'll be praying with you over there. So, and I will take my time from moment, from time to time to pray with you. I mean, because I know, like I have said, 50% of people that are here, just 50%. We are not up to 50% of people under the influence of this telecast. Brother, I want to speak to you. Viewers, like I have said, the Lord has instructed me that anytime I'm talking like this, when I'm so fired, I should talk to you at home. I said to you, those who under the influence of this program, under the influence of this telecast, I break the curse of your life. The challenges you are facing, be broken. The challenges you are facing right now, be broken. Who say you are not a child of God? Sin is Satan. I said to you, you are a child of God. Be blessed in the name of Jesus. That condemnation, that spirit of condemnation, you keep condemning yourself. You cannot see beyond condemnation all the time. You pray, you believe God cannot answer you. That sin you committed yesterday continue to stand before you. The thought you are having now continue to stand before you. I said to you, be covered by the blood of Jesus. Be covered by the blood of Jesus. Be covered by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Viewers all over the world, I want to pray with you once again. I say this is the promise of God that from time to time, if I speak to 20 people, I should speak to the viewer 10 times. I say to you, those of you that are under the influence of this telecast, be blessed in the name of Jesus. Be healed 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 in the name of Jesus.
Be healed in the Jesus.
I don't know that kind of doubt. Can somebody believe that until I enter your city room, before you believe, the word is stronger than TB Joshua. The word, stronger. Who is TB Joshua to the word of God? I'm speaking the word, and I'm the medium that God uses to speak the word. You can't see the word, it moves, it's everywhere. I'm saying, be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed in the name of Jesus. I declare you free. Breakthrough. Brother, I want to see you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.